This is Cool Ray from the Blue Planet, and this is webcam tutorial number 8. Okay, so you're exploring the possibility of becoming a webcam model. Today I'm going to talk about privacy and security. But first, let's take a look at the top 100 webcam models for November 27th. In my experience, there are two main things that would cause a girl to quit being a webcam model or to not become one in the first place. The first one, of course, is having your family or friends find out you're camming. And the second biggest fear, of course, is having a guy from your chat room actually figure out who you really are and where you live. What many webcam websites will do is give you the option to block someone in your geographical area. Now you're thinking, this is exactly what I want. Now nobody from my area is going to be able to see me on cam. But I'm here to tell you that that option doesn't always work. It's very deceiving to think that you're blocking people from your area when you're not. I'm going to use myself as an example here. I live in Ontario, Canada, and I'm able to view every webcam model in Ontario, Canada, no problem at all. I know their settings are telling them they're blocking the province, but I can assure you this setting does not work 100% of the time. The bottom line to all this is that if you're going to become a webcam model, there's always the chance someone you know is going to find you and see you on cam. There's no way to avoid this. The internet is by far not 100% secure at any time. I'm going to get technical here and tell you exactly what is happening with this block feature. And that is, every webcamming website is looking at every guy's IP address. Every computer on the internet is given an IP address. It looks something like this. Now, part of those numbers actually gives a location of where you are based on the internet service provider who's giving you your internet service. So if you're buying your internet service from a company that's outside of your state or outside of your province, then the IP address is not going to reflect the actual location of where you live. All this means is that the blocking feature these webcam websites offer you might work in some cases, but definitely not every case. I'll let you in on a little secret here. I buy my internet access from a company in Germany, and that's why the girls in Ontario and the webcam models in Canada in general can't block me, because my internet service provider is far away and you're blocking the wrong place. It just means that if I'm buying my internet access from another country, I'm sure other guys are doing exactly the same thing. The point I'm trying to make and what I want you to be aware of is that if you're going to become a webcam model, someday, some way, one of your family or friends may just see you on cam. There's no way to avoid it, and no security feature is 100% going to stop it. But even if a guy does buy his internet access from his own home city, he can always use a proxy server to bounce his signal around the country so it looks like you're coming from another city. I won't tell you what a proxy server is, just Google it and look it up. I've one last point to make here, and that is, if a website can actually determine where all these guys live based on their IP address, can the reverse happen? That means, can guys actually find out where models live based on the information they're putting on the internet? Now, the real answer to this is yes. I could probably find a model's house street address based on the information they're putting on the internet. Now, I'm not even going to describe how to do this, because I'm sure if I do, guys will start doing it. So if you're a model and you're worried about this, send me a direct message via Twitter and I can tell you how to avoid doing this. For the record, no, it's not 100% of the webcam models who are providing enough information out there for you to actually track them down if you really wanted to. There are some simple mistakes that some girls are doing, and I'm sure they're not even aware of how much information they're providing. Let's face it, 99% of the guys in your chat room don't care who you really are or where you really are, but that 1% who could actually show up and knock on your door someday, you just want to make sure that can happen. Just keep in mind, there's a lot of technology out there, and most of the time it works for you, but sometimes it will work against you. Just be careful, that's all. I definitely have more to tell you about privacy and security when it comes to webcamming, but I'm going to save that for my next webcam tutorial. But for now, just a few shoutouts to all the sexy girls who send me messages via Twitter. My first shoutout goes to the totally beautiful Lexi Lee. Apparently she was drunk lately on cam, but didn't do anything crazy. Well, we know you're not going to do anything crazy. We love you just the way you are. A big hello to Canadian girl Cassie, who's always so much fun to watch on cam. But not just watch, listen to, because Cassie is loud, loud, loud. She could be an NFL quarterback. A quick shout out to Canadian cam girl Petite Bijou. First time I've ever seen you on cam and in a hotel swimming pool, no doubt, polka dot bikini. I hope to see you again real soon. That was fun. A quick hello to Natalia Gray, who was having computer problems, or was it internet problems, or both. Anyway, that was the problem. Didn't know what the problem was. So I hope it's fixed by now and you're back camming soon. My final shout-out goes to the totally wonderful Eva Mish. No wonder I like you so much. Well, that and the fact that you're so damn pretty. I even made the Eva Mish song, but I took it off YouTube. Maybe I should put it back. Okay, kids, so ends another webcam tutorial. I'll be back very soon with another one, because I have a bunch more planned. Anyway, this is Cool Ray from Canada. Thanks for watching my videos. Don't forget to subscribe to them on YouTube or send me a tweet on Twitter. Bye for now.